Biggest World, changing your mindset.
Truth of the matter is that each and every one of us won't get old till we die. But the most important question that we should ask ourselves is that did we live up to why we're here on Earth? My guest today is one man who believes so much in purpose. Good to have you on another edition of your weekly TV talk show, Biggest World. It's a pleasure to have you join us this week. A quick break, I'll be right back. Don't go away.
This is Biggest World. Good to have you back on the show today. My guest today on the show is one man who has made a landmark in PR industry in Nigeria. Join me to make noise and welcome the man in the house, Mr. Kenneth Ebers. Good to have you on Biggest World.
Thank you so much. I've watched your show a few times and I think it's an honor for me to be here.
You're really doing well. Are you a chief? I can see the cap on your head.
I wish I was, but you know, for my own generation of people, I don't think we'll make many of us chiefs. Actually, I just felt like dressing down a little bit today and looking more like an African.
Yes, like an African man that you are.
Yes, African.
Yeah, Mr. Ken, you are really doing good in the PR industry in Nigeria.
Thank you.
Today we want to look at the role of PR practitioners for the private sector, for the benefit of most people, more especially the startups. A lot of startups die, they said, before the 5 years, some before 7, some don't even survive, some don't even see 2 years. So, could you throw more light about the importance, the relevance of this PR, so that many people could learn?
I think the first thing you want to deal with is when you have an idea that is encapsulated, how do you break it down that when it gets into the digestive process of the minds of the people that they can assimilate it and be able to do something with it? And that's why for me, talking about startups that don't do more than 5 years, I think the problem really is not starting a company, because starting a company sometimes can be like an opinion. An opinion can be something like an idea. Even your two-year-old, if you subject him or her to any serious conversation, you won't be too surprised that they have ideas. But what stands ideas? What differentiates ideas from things that become empires? Are three things for me. One, vision. Two, mission, how you achieve then three, destination, which a lot of people call destiny. Then in between
vision, mission, destination.
Destination.
Did you hear that?
In between the vision and the mission, you have passion. If you were to extend it a bit further.
Yeah.
Then in between the mission and the destination, you have persistence. So if you run on those five legs, I believe very strongly, what happens is that as you go forward with anything that you are hotly in pursuit of, what happens is that you become a source of energy that attracts other centers of energy to yourself. And you find out after a while that the vision begins to grow. Even in the Bible, one of my favorite scriptures, Habakkuk, is take this vision I've given to you, make it, put it down on the tablet and run with it. That people who hear or see will run with you. There's no vision now that ever given, well, it's supposed to be actualized by just one person. But what God expects all of us to do is get on the road. Then we will be able to attract what I call vision helpers or destiny helpers who will help you actualize that. That's on one side. The other thing you talked about is the PR industry. I think you can't talk about the PR industry first and foremost without understanding what PR is. Sometimes people talk about public relations from the textbook definition done maybe 20, 30, 40 years ago. But if you want to simplify public relations for everybody on the street to understand,
the layman on the street to understand,
public relations really is one of the most scientific areas in the social sciences. And it is a process where you sit, look more at the future, judging against your present. Look at the opportunities that are going to be available and advise yourself or your client or whoever you are thinking for on how they can optimize those opportunities that are going to be available. Public relations, unlike quite a lot of other areas of the social sciences, is very futuristic. It never deals with now. When it deals with now, it's looking at now and how now will change in another 10 years. So those are the advice and the counsel to give to people we work for and people we advise. And I think for me, there's been a paradigm shift, as it were, in public relations practice globally. And sometimes when I look at the state of play in the global industry, and I try to juxtapose that to what is happening locally, I feel bad sometimes because, you know, I think it's maybe it's as much as just maybe only 25% of the active participants in the PR industry have been able to latch on to that global dream. We still have PR industry in Nigeria where we run a PR template, a template of practice that's a little bit outdated, you know, and it's a global industry now. If you do a campaign, whether it's a campaign to get somebody to buy into a concept or an idea or crisis management, because of technology, something that you do here is being assessed in America. In the book of James 1:5-6, I said, it's an unstable man is easily blown away. A double-minded man, an unstable person. And a double-minded, as a man with double mind is easily tossed by the wind to and fro.
So there must be a wind.
Yeah, so I think that what normally happens with a lot of people who start up things is they start up things and expect instantaneous results. A lot of us do things because we have seen the end, but we have not seen the process. A lot of us start things because we do it for Mr. A is doing it and got famous, so I could do the same thing and get famous as well. You understand? So for me, what I think is, you know, when you start, you have to tell yourself, other people may have run this course, but there's a difference between running a course and running a journey. Now, a course might be going through a particular terrain, but your journey might be the experiences along that terrain is what makes a different journey different from running a course. And I think that one of the things we need to get people who start up is to be patient, to be focused. When you mix patience and focus, What it does is sharpens your sense of direction and purpose. And purpose is not something that is pleasant at some point, even though purpose always bears fruit at the end. So what people need to learn, like a lot of, it's been very difficult being in business. I can tell you for free that doing business in Nigeria, whether it's a consultancy or producing anything, is the most difficult place economically for a startup. So I think that, you know, those are things that when you have a sense of direction, it will help you to keep you focused, and that will, you know, at the end it always comes well. Then I have also understood, I've had the mind, when I started this, when we started at a consultancy, consulting company in 2006, I also had the opportunity of going to visit people who had done what I wanted to do, or reading about people who had done things that I was dreaming of doing. Oh, yeah. And one thing I found on all of them in common was, number one, there was clarity in the ideas they were taking to the marketplace, and they were ready to work hard as they could
to achieve their purpose and have fun.
Now, when you work hard and you have fun, it means that you can be doing something even when the result is not coming as at when you expect
it to come. You're still be doing
it. There are times I used to come to my office even when nobody was calling me to do any work, and I'd just pick up a book and use that opportunity to improve my knowledge and my skill and be ready for the opportunity that comes. You know, and the time that I've worked for people, I didn't earn. Some people didn't pay me what I was supposed to get. Some people didn't pay me what I was worth or what the. But you know, some people would get very angry and drain all the energy and being upset. But you know what? I just thank God all the step of the way for the opportunity anyway that somebody could find us for the other day, come and help us think this thing through. And those relationships will never allow to go sour, because as a PR person, a relationship that brings you ₦1 or even deprives you of ₦1 can actually tomorrow, you understand? Because a network of relationship creates opportunities, and we've managed that up till now.
According to the PR explanation you gave to us, you said that it's actually planning, looking at being futuristic, planning from now to then.
Yeah.
And if you're one of the most startups, basically in Nigeria, don't even go into that. So how do we solve this problem?
The first thing that has affected us really is the kind of education that we get. And when people are being hired, or companies are hiring our friends, and they want me to sit down and look up, and we find out that because the lacuna, as it were, that we've suffered in society, has eaten not only into the psyche of the people, the economy, as it were, our pockets and all of that. It has also affected us mentally, and it has negatively impacted on the quality of education that we have received. And one of the areas that has suffered the most is, well, first is the sciences, because today we are producing doctors who cannot tell you as much as they would have about body parts and tissues like they would have 30 years ago. We've also graduated a lot of people who come into communications who either study advertising, public relations, or English language first, as it were. These days you see someone with a master's in English and cannot write an application letter. You know, it's that bad. So when you have this coming in, it affects, you know, the first problem you have is a problem of quality. Okay? Now when you find people you can train, you find out that or where you have taken your time to get people running, you spend time to get them up for the race. Sometimes when they're ready to start performing, they're either moving somewhere else. So manpower has been a big issue, because when you have people who are behind in terms of their level of capacity, it becomes very difficult and challenging to show them a vision that is so far away
from where
they are, you know, and they find it very difficult to come. So in the process, you have a lot of people who are job hunters. We're in a place where you need career-oriented people, because the difference between both is the job people will always be come to the office and look for a place because they don't have a place to go to earn a salary or an income. While the people who are career oriented are always going to be in that place where every step of the way, you know, they know this is about my career, I'm a PR person, I'm an advertising person. Every activity from this point on should be taking me higher up the ladder.
Wow, that's a wonderful one.
I do.
Mr. Ken, it's Ebbers. Career-oriented. I like that word you use there. That's actually one of the reasons we are sitting here with you today. Venus World TV Talk Show is a role model TV talk show. Actually, someone said you are actually a role model. You're supposed to be on this show. So, probably it's someone you know very well. We're going up, very happy you join us here. Let's hear one or two questions she has to ask you about your person and what you do in society.
Wow. If someone said I'm a role model, actually, as you were singing, you know, I could feel butterflies flying in my belly. You know, because I think a role model is a tough call for anyone. Yeah, because a role model is someone who people find inspiring.
Yeah.
People find original. And people trust.
I like that one.
Yeah, and I don't know if I've reached that level for a young man, but whoever feels I'm a role model, I'm deeply honored. And all I ever wanted to do in my life, I'm a man with a lot of flaws, made mistakes in my life, like a lot of other young people have. I've taken bad decisions or made bad decisions, like a lot of people have. But one of the things that has kept me going, I think, when I look back, because if you expect me to speak very honestly, where I feel, man, I feel like I got it wrong, I feel like a pig, should anybody even pay attention to me? But I think the thing that works when you're a child of God, or a believer in God, believer in the God who gives vision, like David, like several other people in the Bible, that anytime you get things wrong, you can go to the source.
I like that. Going back to the source, that's when you know where you're coming from. Hold on for my special guest today on this show. This is Biddy Sword. My guest today on the show is Mr. Kenneth Ebbers. Mr. Ken, this is the lady who said you are a role model. She's somebody you know very well.
Yes, I've known her for years. If you looked at my phone, I stole her name as the very first visitor to my office in 2006.
Wow! Did you hear that? That's a good story.
Interestingly, when she walked in, it was just this three-bedroom apartment, you know, a big, gigantic sitting room. And you know all that, wasn't it? Just a single chair and nothing else.
Oh, God.
And I know when she came and visited me at the time, I used to walk into this place, and because it was the first office I was setting up, and there was no takeover furniture or handover furniture or hand, you know. And so I just had this little chair I took from my dining room at home. And I recall, I made her sit on the chair, and I stood while we talked.
That brings me to passion and persistency.
Yeah.
Well, you talked to us about, please tell us about what he's talking about. How was it when you visited him in that office that he's talking about, and look at a very big office here today?
Yeah. First of all, I'm very proud of him. He has really done well in this time pass, and he's still doing tremendously well now. I remember the first time I got to his office, he said something to me which really inspired me and propelled me to where I am today too. He said, Ngozi, that even though I'm not here yet, professionally, but I know I'm getting somewhere. But from what I've seen right now, he has really gotten there. And to his own vision, he has not really gotten to the top. But I really know one thing, that he has this thing in him. Every word he says keep propelling me to do more. And every word he says is really is an achiever. He has achieved so much. He has inspired us as upcoming PR practitioners. We look up to him. And I'm really proud to say that he has really, really made us proud. Everywhere I go to, I beat my chest and said, Mr. Ken Eggers has really made PR, given PR a new face. So I'm really proud of you, sir.
Thank you very much.
And keep the flight flying.
We are really proud of you, Mr. Ken.
Thank you very much.
Wow, how many people are proud of you today in the society? Did you hear that? She is proud of him. I'm floating.
I'm floating. You know? But one of the things I, for a young man, I appreciate it when I ran for office. I sought a seat in the House of Representatives in Kwashiorkor to represent the people of Ubra and Etun, and I know. When I came out of the first outing in politics, and everybody was, wow, who's this person? He sounds sharp. And I don't sound sharp. I'm just a man who knows what God, who I'm born
to do.
Yeah. The thing about doing what you're born to do is that along the line, you, without realizing or even wanting to, you also help people light the fire in themselves regarding what they're born to do. One of the lessons I've learned in this life as a young man is that I have met so many people who, for the first time, connecting with their purpose in life. And for me, I feel honored when people find me worthy and say, oh, we think you're doing something exemplary. I remember when I didn't win the primary, in the party primary, I felt heartbroken. I went into the dumps for 3 days because I put the best of 3 years. I ran an American, and I ran a campaign that was too advanced for that locality. But at the end of the day, I told myself I wanted to be different. So I'm going to run this the way it comes to me. And I wanted to always stand out and let people know this one. Now, even though I didn't get the ticket, I think I made a huge enough impact for the former government to invite me to the cabinet to serve as special advisor on strategic planning. You know, and when I walked, I remember the first day I walked into the executive chambers to sit with about 30 people to decide on the future of about 4 million Kwashiorkorians. And the first thing that hit me, oh wow, look at how far God had brought
you down. It's okay.
I wasn't focusing more on the depression from not winning the seat, but I was now looking at the fact that from a guy who grew up on the streets of Lagos, hawked oranges, sold bread, that could, you understand? And the journey has found me here. And I can only be grateful to God, and I know deep in the depth of my heart that there's something bigger that the Lord wishes to do with me. And all I seek to do at this point in my life and going into the future, regardless of my ineptitude, my weaknesses, is just make myself a vessel of honor for the God who created me and sent me on this errand. We heard a lot of prophets talk about 2016 as the year of the doom for a lot of people. I don't see it that way. I see it's going to be the year of opportunities for entrepreneurs, for startups. There's going to be less focus on oil that comes from the ground, and there'll be more interest in what comes out of people. And I want everybody out there, anything that's been there inside you, you've been procrastinating about, this is the year to do it, because that's the spirit of 2016. Thank you.
This is the year that so many people are going to focus on what comes out of you, not what comes from the oil that Nigerian or Africa has been known from. God, I'm shivering. I don't know what to say. This man here said it all. But I can't forget what he said earlier in this discussion. He said passion and persistence. And that is major reason or major thing most startup, many of us who owns company or who wish to start a company lack passion and persistence. Remember, it's going to be rough. It will never be rosy the way we say it. It's never going to be the way you assume it's going to be. At one point, you're like, what am I even doing? But if you have the passion, if you persist, Mr. Ken Ebers said you will get there. And Biddy's was sure saying you will get there. That much will be taken today on the show. Remember to keep a date with us. Same station, same day, next week. Bye!
Bye.
Bye.